is what convinced us. The blood is a speaking blood. Convinced us that it would be better to serve righteousness. There are greater redemptions. There are wider opportunities. The problem is this. We live in the spirit, but very few of us walk in the spirit. When you are put over two people, make the light shine. I know I have preached many messages, but if there is any practical message, practical, that I've preached, that I would want the whole world to hear, is on this matter, dreams. It's on this matter, dreams. Because as if we are being kept in a case, and we have been shut out from our very experience. Apart from a dream journal, what other thing do I need? I need a memory journal. Genesis 42, verse 9. A memory journal. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2 to 3. Let's go to Habakkuk 2. Habakkuk 2, verse 2 to 3. Remember, dreams are visions. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision. God, he doesn't waste visions. So he said, write the vision. And he said, and make it plain on tables. I like the way the message puts this verse. You will love it. MSG. I love the way he puts it. Listen, if I were you, when I have a dream, you use capital letters. Everybody say, write it in capital letters. Listen, oh, you are just too far. I say, write it in capital letters. He said, and then God answered, write this. Write what you see. Write it out in big block letters. So that it can be read on the run. And I like the verse 3. The vision, the message is a witness pointing to what is coming. It aches for the coming. It can hardly wait. And it doesn't lie. If it seems slow in coming, wait. It's on its way. It will come right on time. Hallelujah. Oh my God. Let's read it again. It's wonderful. And then God answered, write this. Write what you see. When you dream, do you see? Write it. People, write it. Do you have a dream journal? Write it. Don't just, oh, it's in my head. It's in my head. Write it. God said, write what you see. Write it out. Use big block letters. Oh, this dream journal book, it must last this year. So when you bought it, you are making sure. Listen, write it in big. If I write it too big, next month I have to come and buy another one. It will finish quickly. Look at your face. It will finish quickly. I'm not establishing a law. I'm preaching grace. Else I would have said, anybody in the name of Jesus, if you get a dream journal, write it in big block letters. If you write it in small letters, it won't manifest. But that's not the case. Anyway, under grace, God said, write what you see. Tell somebody, tonight, write what you see. Tell another, tonight, write what you see. Write what you see. Write it out in big block letters so that it can be read on the run. Oh, verse 3. This vision message is a witness. It is a witness. It is pointing to what is coming. I remember I told you, when the dreams begin to repeat, then you know that it's a matter, what? Established by God, and that God would what? Would ensure that it's shortly, I can hear you. I can hear you. So then the message says, this vision message is a witness. And it is pointing to what is coming. And you know what? It aches for the coming. That is to say, it can't wait. It can hardly wait. And it doesn't lie. If it seems slow in coming, just wait. It's on its way. It will come right on time. Pastor, I've dreamt 7 times that I'm wearing wedding gown. Oh, sister. Hey. 7 times. I have dreamt. Pastor, I'm turning 35. I have dreamt 7 times that I'm in wedding. My sister, wait. It will come to pass. God is determined to bring it to pass. Don't, Pastor, I've dreamt, sir. I've dreamt. Every time, this wedding, I've been, it aches to come. It aches to manifest. It aches. It will come to pass. I said, it will come to pass. In the name of Jesus. The one that screams in louder, it will manifest. Come on. Bobolos Mandebaya. Jesus. And some of the times, it seems slow in coming. Brother, wait. It seems slow in coming. Pastor, I have dreamt 13 times. I was wearing winter clothes. Hey! Do you wear winter clothes in Ghana? My brother, I can't hear you. It will come to pass in the name of Jesus. And you know when you appear there, you will go there in winter. Jesus. Don't tell me there is snow in South Africa. I don't like that snow. It will come to pass. It's on its way. It will come right on time. When you write, it will come right on time. You know, that's why I wrote it in big block letters. You see, it's an expression of faith. I'm not writing it small. I'm writing it small as if I don't believe. You didn't get what I'm saying. I'm writing it small. I dot. Who says that one? Who's I slash slash? What is I dot? I slash, yes, I saw. How can you start saying I with small? Are you a small I? No. Come on, shout. I'm a big I. Shout again. Me.
I'm
a big I.
When I write about me,
it's not in small letters.
It's not in small letters.
Big block letters. Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Shout and give him glory. Glory to God. Write out the vision so that I can be read on the run. Amen. Another place is memory. Genesis 42 verse 9. And Joseph remembered the dreams. Joseph dreamt. You know that dream already. His brothers and his sisters, his father and his mother, everybody was bending, bowing to him. They said, oh, there cometh the dreamer. He was dreaming that they called him a dreamer. The Bible said he dreamt another dream. You are not getting what I'm saying. Do you see the repetition of dreams and how that God will establish it? Pharaoh dreamt twice. Amen?
Amen.
Double twice. Then Joseph, he also dreamt double twice. And you know, whenever you dream double twice, the good thing is that it expands. He dreamt. The first one, he saw sheep bowing to a sheep. The next one, he saw his father, his mother. The first one was concerning his 11 brothers. The second matter, he added his father and his mother. They all come and bow. He dreamt twice. Don't joke with repeated dreams. The Bible said, and he dreamt that dream on the same count. It had to do with the same thing. And he dreamed yet another dream. Repetitive dreams. I think I'm majoring on that tonight. Repetitive dreams. He dreamt yet another dream. Did it come to pass? Because God had established it. And God was determined that it would come to pass. And Joseph knew that if you dream twice, the fact is that it will come to pass. So as soon as he entered the palace, they said, king said, I've dreamt again. He said, king, the first and the second, they are the same. It will come to pass. Behold, I have dreamed a dream more. More dreams. Oh, the church is not alive. I'm sure from now we'll have more dreams. Hallelujah. More dreams. I have dreamed a dream more. More. I can't hear you. I said more. And behold, the sun and the moon and the 11 stars, they were all bowing to me. My question is, how does the sun bow? Have you ever seen a sun bowing before? It is only Joseph who can tell us. How will a moon bow? Don't let somebody intimidate the facts of your dream. Listen, if you tell people, I dreamt and the sun was bowing, they say, hey, since you were born, have you seen sun bowing before? Don't tell them, it is my dream, oh. I said the sun was bowing. And the moon was also bowing. They were all paying obeisance to me. That is how, in a dream world, everything is possible. Oh, you didn't get it. You see yourself from a skyscraper. Tell it like it is. I dreamt and I was standing on 1,500. The 1,500 floor. And there was another building over there. That one was 3,000 floors. By the time I realized, I was flying. It is your dream. I believe I can fly. I said, I believe I can fly. Don't you see that sometimes when you dream, you fly? Oh. Who is there to limit your dreams? Dream big. Dream big. Dream big. Dream big. Nobody can kill you for dreaming big. The sun, the moon, and the 11 stars, they came. They came. NIV. Then he had another dream. And he told it to his brothers. Listen, he said, I had another dream, oh. And this time, the first one was sheep. But this time around, the one that I told you that you people got jealous and intimidated, this time, it was not sheep, so. This time, it was the sun. It was the moon. And the 11 stars, they were bowing down to me. I have been preaching. How does the sun and the moon and the stars bow? Oh, this is Joseph. Verse 10. He was talking to his brothers. I always told you, when you are sharing your dream, there is always somebody, a third party who is not around that you are talking to, who is listening. I told you. Who was he talking to? To his brothers. By the time he realized, when he told his father as well as his father rebuked him and said, what is this dream you had? What? What do you mean? Will your mother and I and your brothers actually come and bow down to the ground before you? The interpretation of the dream. As soon as he said that, there was a dream killer. They said, this guy, the dreamer coming, let's finish him. It is a secret. You should have just kept it to yourself. Every time when you're walking, you're like, sun, moon, and stars. You just go on with your confession. Sun, moon, and stars. Bow to me. You just, sun, moon, and stars. Bow to me. Oh, it's real. I said it's real. Hallelujah. It's what? It's real. It's real. It's real. 42 verse 9. And Joseph remembered the dreams which he dreamed of them and said to them, you are spies. You are spies. You have come to see the nakedness of the land. To see the nakedness of the land, you are come. You guys are spies. He remembered. Now, when Joseph went out, He was about 17 years. And now he's a prince. How many years, we don't know. Because he went and served in the house of Potiphar. And went and served in prison. And then he went and became a prince. And around this time, remember, 40 years had elapsed. Because they had gone through the first 7 years of abundance. And they are now going into the 7 years of famine and dryness. And the brothers walked in. He remembered. I dreamt this. I want to ask you, can you tell me any dream you had when, like, 16 years ago? I dreamt 16 years ago. Very few of us can. Memory. You keep it in memory. And he remembered. The next way to also record your dreams, apart from a book, apart from keeping it in memory. And remember, the way to make your memory powerful is to write. Amen?
Amen.
Look at me for a moment. Today's message. How will you remember it? By writing. You remember, but the safest way to remember this message is to write it so that you always consult it. So as soon as it appears, it's fresh in your mind because you always go through it. The dream journal. Another thing, a memory journal, another way to remember your dream is to use a heart journal. Daniel 7, verse 1, 2, and 28. A heart journal to keep it in your heart. In the first year of Belshazzar, king of Babylon, Daniel had a dream and visions of his head upon his bed. Then he wrote the dream and told the sum of the matters. Daniel spake and said, I saw in my vision by night, and behold, the four winds of the heaven strove upon the great sea. Verse 28. He that too is the end of the matter. As for me, Daniel, my cogitations much troubled me, and my countenance changed in me, but I kept the matter in my heart. Hey, verse 1. Where did he write it? Where did he write it? Oh, church, talk to me. Where did he write it? He wrote it in a book. Verse 28. Where did he keep it? In his heart. Do you know why? If you have a dream journal and you just forget, and it is not in your heart, it's not in your memory, it's not in your heart, by the time you realize you have 62 dream journals. Because if you should live for 62 more years and every year you are getting a dream journal, then it means, and you will not be able to tell which of the books you wrote it even in. But you see, as you write, the Bible said, and I kept the matter in my heart. So another place to store the dreams is in your heart. How do you keep a matter in your heart? The more you pray, the more you release the message, the more your heart follows it, the matter is kept in your heart. Oh, Lord, you spoke to me 15 years ago. The more you pray it, the more you pray it, the more you engage it in spiritual matters, it now sticks to your heart. But I kept the matter in my heart. As for me, Daniel, my cogitations much troubled me. We did cogitations and countenance last Sunday. My cogitations much troubled me, and my countenance changed in me. But I kept the matter in my heart. So where do you keep your dreams? In your heart. Keep it in your heart. Let your heart follow steadily after it. Another place to keep it. I shared on that. Luke 2:51, 2 Timothy 1:14. A vision came to Mary concerning the birth of Jesus. And he went down with them and came to Nazareth, and was subject unto them. But his mother kept all these sayings in her heart. And that had to do with the life of Jesus. The heart is a repository. The heart is a repository. It's a storage system that God planted in you. So whatever communications God brings to you, not only in dreams, but also in visions, and the things you hear in open visions, in the things God speaks into your ear, you are supposed to also store them in your heart. Now, when you store them in your heart, it's not safe. There is also another place you have to hand it. I think I taught on that, 2 Timothy 1:14, the Holy Ghost. That good thing which was committed unto thee, keep by the Holy Ghost, which dwelleth in us. So the greatest repository of your being is the Holy Ghost. The storage facility of your being is the Holy Ghost. Keep a dream journal. Keep it in memory. Keep it in your heart. Keep it with the Holy Ghost. When you finish, then I'll talk. In everyday life, in IT, what is the safest way to keep a document? I can't hear you. Talk, say anything, say anything. In a drive. Backup. Internet. Good. Do you know what? You don't keep a file in one backup. The safest way, you keep it here, keep it here, keep it there, keep it there. So if this one crashes, you pick it from here. If you go and it's not working, you keep it from here. If you go and that place too is not working, you pick it from here. That is how come the Bible said, have a book, have a mind, have a heart, have the Holy Ghost. Keep it in a book, keep it in your mind, keep it in your heart, keep it with the Holy Ghost. Form backups for one matter that was communicated to you because it's precious. If my mind fails me, I have a book. If the book burns, I have a heart. If I die, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. I know sometimes the enemy will come so much after you that because of one dream journal that you have, a book that you have, he can burn down a whole house. You don't understand. Because what you are talking about, if one of your great-grandchildren should read it, that God said, in the fourth generation, this will happen. And will happen this way, and this way, and this way. And one will become a president of this country. And he's having cogitations that he should become the president. As soon as he read, hey, oh, it's that. Agbena, my great-grandfather, he saw that me, I'll be a president of this country. I read it. You didn't get that one. What will happen to that child? Straight up. He knows this one is determined. It must surely come to pass. I wish a certain president will see his great grandfather's dreams. How I wish that a certain communication. Do you think Moses would be afraid to go to Egypt if he read Abraham's dreams in a journal? He would have just calculated. 400 years, it's up. We are going out with great substance. It was written. With what boldness? Jeremiah, he spoke of the timelines of Israel's release. Daniel was reading the book of Jeremiah. Ha! I understood by the books. Time is up. People, we are leaving this place. And I, Daniel, I understood because Jeremiah wrote this prophecy in a book. It's not a book that you put on your dining table. You don't make it accessible by any man on earth. If you see somebody handling it, you just go to the person with an angry face. Give me my book. What are you reading in that? Is it your concern? Is it your head? Is it your dreams? Is it your book? Because if somebody gets the book, in the first year of his reign, I, Daniel, understood by books the number of years whereof the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah the prophet. that he would accomplish 70 years in the desolations of Jerusalem. I understood by books. These are reasons for which the enemy might want to fight what you have written. And so whatever you write in the name of Jesus, you declare that it is preserved from evil eye. Because now, if you are going to read, that's how come you have to understand the dream journal. You dedicate it. You pray over it. You work the dream journal. That if somebody picks the book, listen. You see, some of us, we don't understand spiritual things. I can give you a book, and you can't read it because of what I've done to the book. You don't understand? The Bible said, this is a book. That when it's delivered to the learned, he says, I can't read. Why? Because it is sealed. Went to here the other time when I picked the book and I sealed it and I said they should read. They could not even as much as open the book to see what was in the book. How many of you are here in that meeting? It is sealed. So the dream journal must be worked. Otherwise, that witch or wizard in the same house with you walks into your room. And the vision of all is become as unto you, is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed. Which men deliver to one that is learned, saying, read this, I pray thee. And he said, I cannot, for it is sealed. So when you get your dream journal, you have to seal it. Somebody say, how do I seal it? Later. Not tonight. So that if somebody comes in contact with it, the Bible said, the vision of all. So that means that all visions can be sealed. Can you imagine that even God, the book that he gave to Jesus to be given to his angel that should be passed on to John and to all the brethren when he spoke of the seven thunders. He said, hey, John, that matter, seal it. With Daniel, he said, this book is sealed until the end of time. So there is a sealing of books. So your dream journal, you have to seal it. You must learn to seal it. Hallelujah. And I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within and on the backside, sealed with seven seals. And this book was sealed in the days of Daniel. You know that already. And when it was opened, inside the seal was a seal. And he said, of the things you heard the seven thunders speak, seal it. But thou, Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro and knowledge shall be increased. The seven thunders. The seven thunders. The revelation of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And cried with a loud voice. And as when a lion roared, and when he had cried, seven thunders uttered their voices. And when the seven thunders had uttered their voices, I was about to write, and I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, seal up those things which the seven thunders uttered, and write them not. Amen.
Amen.
So learn to seal your dream journal. And if God permits, and I'm granted the grace, I'll talk about how to seal a book. But I don't have the leave to do it now. Amen.
Amen.
All right.